Blood sugar is very important to be able to monitor. It helps you know whether or not you're having good blood sugar control or if you're over-medicating your blood sugar. So typically what we like to do is we like to use both a fasting blood sugar and something called a hemoglobin A1C. A fasting blood sugar is when you would take your blood sugar approximately a half hour before eating to be able to let you know what your blood sugar is. And your goal is typically going to be somewhere between 80 and 130 on a glucometer. Hemoglobin A1C is more like an average over the course of 3 months, and typically at a doctor's office, you'd like to get a hemoglobin A1C anywhere between 2 to 4 times a year to see if you're on track with your blood sugar goal. And typically for most people, you want to have the hemoglobin A1C goal of less than 7%, but sometimes if you're an older person or you have other illnesses, your goal might be more around less than 8%. So a glucometer is a little machine, and its job is to tell you what your blood sugar is. Typically they come in a kit, so you can have a glucometer. You'd also have something called lancets, which are kind of like these little needles that you use to poke the side of your finger so that you can get a droplet of blood. You also get test strips, which are used to connect to the glucometer and help with the collection of the blood sample for your blood sugar. And so the way that you go about using a glucometer is you have your kit, your test strips, your lancets. You also want to have at least 2 alcohol wipes to be able to clean off your finger. And really the first step is washing your hands with some soap and water to make sure that they're clean. Taking a little alcohol wipe and wiping off your finger. You take a lancet, poke the side of your finger, squeeze a little droplet of blood, take another alcohol wipe, wipe that first droplet of blood. That's not the one that you want to use when you're testing your sugar. You're going to squeeze your finger again to get a second droplet of blood, and then you take your little test strip, connect it to your glucometer, which you want to make sure is on, and then you put that droplet of blood on the edge of your test strip. Allow it a little bit of time to absorb. It should just take a couple of seconds, and then you'll get a value on your glucometer that'll let you know what your blood sugar is.
Hypoglycemia is defined as a blood sugar less than 70, but some people may feel effects of low blood sugar at different levels. Reasons for low blood sugars include not eating enough, being sick, drinking alcohol, exercising, or taking too much insulin.
So if your blood sugar is less than 70 when you're checking it, I want you to do something called the 15-15 rule. You want to give yourself approximately 15 grams of carbohydrates. So how do you measure that? So 15 grams of carbohydrates can come as half a cup of juice, whether that's orange juice or apple juice. It could also mean having a couple of hard candies. Sometimes that means you have to look at the nutritional label and kind of do a little bit of math to add up 15 grams of carbohydrates. Another possibility is that there are little glucose tablets that come in a small cylinder. You take approximately 4 of those, and those can also equal about 15 grams. And if you're really low on options, you can even do something as simple as a tablespoon of sugar, corn syrup, or honey. After you've had those 15 grams of carbohydrates, you should wait 15 minutes so that your body can absorb that sugar. Then you should check your blood glucose. If your blood glucose is then above 70, that means you've had enough sugar and you're no longer having hypoglycemia or this low blood sugar. If it's still less than 70, you should take another 15 grams of carbohydrates, wait another 15 minutes, recheck your blood sugar, and then if it's above 70, that means that your blood sugar is in a safe value. If you're consistently having low blood sugars, it's probably time to go to the hospital. If you have uncontrolled diabetes, there can be a lot of scary complications that can come with it. Fortunately, if you monitor your blood sugar and you meet a certain goal or range of blood sugars, you can actually prevent yourself from getting some of those scary complications that can come with uncontrolled diabetes.
The biggest barrier to controlling diabetes is understanding how diabetes works and how to manage it. It's really important that you have a good relationship with your doctor and you can talk to them about how to best control your diabetes.